Hello friends, this is Ayush and in this video we'll be discussing the quant section of CMAT 2019 paper. In this video we'll have questions from the chapters permutation and combination, probability, time and work, time speed distance, mensuration and geometry. There'll be a total of 14 questions in the video. So let's begin with it. Here is question number 1 on the screen. It's a question from probability. So let's try to figure it out. Management Institute has 6 senior professors and 4 junior professors. So senior ki baat kare, there are 6 and junior there are 4. A total of 10 professors are there. What we need to do is 3 professors are selected at random, okay, for a government project. So in case if I am talking in terms of a question of probability, the probability that at least one of the junior professors would get selected. So what we need to find out is favorable cases and total cases. So first of all, talking about favorable cases, the favorable cases will be such that at least one junior professor should be selected. So in order to calculate this, what I'll do is we'll calculate the total number of cases. Total 10 professors are there and we have to select any 3 randomly out of them. So 10c3 is the total number of cases. If we'll subtract the cases when only senior professors are selected, that is 0 junior professor is selected, we'll get the cases when at least one junior professor is selected. So I'll subtract the cases when only senior professors are selected. Out of the 6 senior professors, I have to select 3. So when I solve the value, I'll get the value of the cases when at least one junior professor is selected. So on solving, I'll get the value as 10c3 is 10 into 9 into 8 upon 3 factorial, that is 6. So on solving, I'll have 2, I'll have 3, I'll have 1, I'll have 4. So that will be 3 into 4, 120 minus 6 into 5 into 4 upon 3 factorial, that's 6. 6 to 6 will get cancelled out, minus 20. So equals to 100. Right. So talking in terms of probability, probability equals to favorable cases, that is 100 upon total cases, that is 10c3. Okay. So it's 100 upon total cases, 10c3. We have just calculated to be 120. On cancellation, we'll get the answer as 5 by 6. So the probability for this question is 5 by 6. The correct answer for question number 1 is option B, that's 5 by 6. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 2 is on the screen. It's a question from mensuration. Let's try to figure it out. A rectangular box of width A, length B and height C has a solid cylinder of height C and of diameter A placed within it. Right. Now, later the values of A, B, C as 6, 8, 10 are given to us in the question. What they've asked us is how much volume is left in the rectangular box. So to find out the volume left in the rectangular box, what we need to do is we have to subtract the volume of the cylinder from the volume of the cuboidal box. Right. So for the cuboidal box, the volume is given by L into B into H, that is 6 into 8 into 10 minus volume of cylinder is given as pi r. Now, since the diameter of the cylinder is a, which is 6, so radius will be 3, so it will be pi r square, that is 3 square, and h will be 10. So, on solving, it will be 6 into 8, 48 into 10 is 480, minus 3 square is 9 into 10, 90 pi. We do not need to solve it further because the answer or the options are given in the form of pi itself. So, the correct answer should be 480 minus 90 pi. So for question number 2, as we can see in option D, option B, 480 minus 90 pi is the correct answer for question number 2. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 3 is on the screen. It's a question from time, speed and distance. So we'll just try to figure it out. Speed of 3 cars in the ratio 5 is to 4 is to 6. So speed the ratio for the 3 cars is given to us as 5 ratio 4 ratio 6. What we need to find out is the ratio of time taken by the amp to travel the same distance. Now, if the distance is same, we can simply say that speed is inversely proportional to time. So, agar speed ka ratio 5, 4, 6, hai, time ka ratio, we can simply say inverse hoga, that is 1 by 5 is to 1 by 4 is to 1 by 6 hona chahiye. Ab, since the ratio is in terms of fractions, to simplify the value, what I will do is I will take the LCM. So, 5, 4, 6 ka LCM, I will take it to be 60. So this will be 12 is to 15 is to 10. Cancelling 60 among the three values, we'll have the ratio as 12:15:10, which is the correct answer for this question. So for question number 3, the correct answer is option D, that is 12:15:10. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 4 is a question from Time and Work. We'll just check it out. Rajesh can check quality of 1000 items in 5 hours. So if we are talking about Rajesh, 5 hours mein 1000 items ka quality check karta hai. So in 1 hour he must have checked, or he can check the quality of 1000 upon 5, that's equal to 200 units. And when I'm talking about Rakesh, Rakesh can complete 75% of the same job. 75% of same job means 1000 is 750 units in 3 hours. So if Rakesh can complete 3 hours mein 750 unit, in 1 hour he must have completed 750 upon 3, that is equals to 250 units. Now if both of them started working together and Rakesh stops after 2 hours, the time required for 1300 items. So we'll just take it out. For the first 2 hours, both of them were working. So they must have completed 200 plus 250 in 1 hour multiplied by 2. That is equals to 415 to 2, it's 900 units into first 2 hours. Now Rakesh left the job. So how many units were left? A total of 1300 units were to be checked, out of which we have already checked 900 units. So units left were 400, and Rajesh takes 1 hour to check 200 units. So for 200 units, since Rajesh is taking 1 hour, for 1 unit Rajesh must be taking 1 upon 200, and for 400 units Rajesh must have taken 400 upon 200, that is 2 hours. So total time taken is, initially for the first 2 hours both of them were working, and then Rakesh left the job and Rajesh completed the remaining job in 2 hours. So total of 4 hours was taken to complete the job. So the correct answer is 4 hours. For question number 4, option D, 4 hours is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 5 is on the screen. It's again a question from mensuration. So we'll just take it out. In a building, there are 30 cylindrical pillars. Okay. The radius of each pillar is 35 centimeter and the height is 5 meter. Okay. I'll just write down. 30 is the radius, 35 centimeter is the radius, which is equal to 35 upon 100 meter, and the height is 5 meter. Okay. Find out the cost of painting the curved surface. So we need to find out the curved surface of cylinder. So curved surface area is equals to 2 pi, that's 22/7, r, that's 35/100, h, that is 5. Right. So if we'll calculate the curved surface area, I'll cancel out 7/35. This is 5. 5 se ye gaya 20 mein. 5 se ye gaya 4 mein. 2 se ye gaya 2 mein. And 2 se ye gaya 11 mein. So ultimately, the curved surface area of one cylinder is 11 meters square. What we need to find out is the cost of painting half the number of pillars. Total pillars were 30. Pillars to be painted is half, so pillars to be painted is equals to 15. So total curved surface area that is to be painted is 15 into the curved surface area of 1, that's 11 meters square, equals to 165 meters square, and the cost is rupees 10 per meter square. So total expenditure is 165 into 10, that is equals to 1650 rupees. That should be the correct answer. So for question number 5, option A, 1650 is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 6 is on the screen. What we are doing is 3 solids. Again, a question from mensuration. 3 solids of solid cubes of size 1 centimeter, 6 centimeter, and 8 centimeter are melted together to form a new cube. Now the thing that we need to take care of is, while we are melting different objects together to form a new object, volume in the first case and the second case always remains the same. So let's calculate the volume of the first case when three solid cubes are melted together. Volume of the first cube is 1 cube, then second cube is 6 cube, and third cube is 8 cube. And this should be equal to the volume of the new cube with the side A, that's A cube. So 1 cube is 1, 6 cube is 216, and 8 cube is 512, which is equals to A cube. On solving, we'll have 729 equals to A cube. This will give us A equal to 9. So the concept that we have got is that in case if we are melting three solid cubes of side 1, 6 and 8 centimeter respectively, and we are trying to form a new cube, the new cube will be of side 9 centimeter. This is something we have calculated. Find the surface area of the cube so far. Surface area of the cube that we have to calculate is 6a square. Since we know that a equals 9, so it will be 6 into 9 into 9. 9 into 9 is 81 into 6 is 486 centimeter square. So the curved surface area of the new solid or the new cube so formed will be 486 centimeter square. That is option B is the correct answer for question number 6. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 7. Again, one more question from menstruation. So as we can see, a number of questions were there from the concept of menstruation. We'll just try to figure out this question as well. It costs rupees 6,000 and rupees 6,100 respectively to paint four walls of two square halls of the same height. Now there are two square halls. Square halls means the length and the breadth or the width of the hall will be equal, right? And the height can be different. If length of one of the hall exceeds the length of the other by 1 meter, and the cost of painting is rupees 5 per square meter. Okay, so what I'm doing is this is hall 1. And this is hall 2. I'm assuming the side to be of length x. So it will be x plus 1 in the second case. And height is same in both the cases. So let it be h in both the cases. So cost of painting the four walls. So area of the four walls will be given as 4x h for the first case. And 4x plus 1 into h for the second case, right? This is the area that we have obtained. If we'll multiply it by the cost per meter square, that's 5. We'll get the total expenses, which is 6,000. And if we'll multiply this equation by 5, we'll get the total expenses as 6,100. Now, the easiest way to solve this type of equation is that what we can do is we can divide the two equations. So it is 4x plus 1 h into 5 equal to 6100 upon, it will be 4xh 5 upon my 6000. What I'll do, 5 say 5 cancel, 4 say 4 cancel, and h say h cancel. Yahan pe 0 say 0 cancel. Again, I can cancel out one more 0. So the ratio left is x plus 1 upon x equal to 61 upon 60. On cross multiplying, we'll have 60x plus 60 equal to 61x. On subtracting, x equal to 60 is the value of the side that we have got. What is being asked upon is to calculate the height of the two walls. So putting the value in the equation, 4 into x is 60 into h into 5 equal to 6000, we'll get h equal to 6000 upon 4 into 60 into 5. 0 says 0 cancel. This 1 and this is 100. This is 1 and this is 25. This is 1 and this is 5. So the value of height turns out to be 5 meters. So for question number 7, option B, 5 meters is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 8. Again, one more question from menstruation. So let's take it out. It's the length, breadth, height of a rectangular cuboid in the ratio 1 to 3. So what I can do is I can assume the length to be 1. I can assume the breadth to be 2 and the height to be 3. Right? So what they have asked is, if length, breadth and height are increased by 100% each, then what would be the increase in volume? Okay. In the second case, my length will be increased by 100%. So it will be 2. Breadth will be double, that's 4. And height will be double, that's 6. In case if I'm trying to calculate the volume in the first case, it should be equals to 1 into 2 into 3, that is equals to 6. And volume in the second case will be equals to 2 into 4 into 6, That's 8 into 6 is 48. What they've asked is the percentage increase in the volume of cuboid. So as we can see, there is an increment of 42 because the volume of 6 is becoming a volume of 48. So there is an increment of 42 over 6 into 100. So that is something we can say it's an increment of 700%, or we can say the volume is becoming 7 times of itself because of the increment of 100% in each of the length, breadth and height. So in case we are talking about question number 8, the correct answer is option A, that is 7 times. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 9 is on the screen. Let's try to figure it out. Again, this is the first question from permutation and combination. Okay, there are 6 tasks and 6 person. So I'll just make 6 blanks for the 6 tasks we have. Right. Task 1 cannot be assigned either to person 1 or to person 2. Right. And task 2 must be assigned either to person 3 or to person 4. So what I'll do is I'll assume the first case when task 2 is assigned to third person. So the third person has already occupied the task. That's only one option is there. Okay. And then task 1 cannot be assigned to 1 and 2. Third has already occupied task 3. So there are only 3 options left for this position. After that, all the tasks are open for all the people. So we'll have 4 options and then 3, 2 and 1. So on multiplying, we'll have 72 cases. I'll take the second case when task 2 is assigned to person number 4. So this will be fourth person. That is only one option. We'll have 3 options because 4 cannot be assigned task 1 and 1, 2 cannot be assigned task 1. Right. So the 3 options are left, and after that it's an open case for all. So it will be 4, 3, 2, 1 again. That's 72. So a total of 72 plus 72, that is 144 ways are there to get the task done in such conditions. So for question number 9, the correct answer is option A, that's 144. Okay, let's go ahead to the next question, a question from probability. So what is the probability of drawing a king or a heart from a deck of cards, right? So in case if we are going for this, we are talking in terms of heart. There are total 13 cases. King, there are total 4 cases. So either heart or king will have 13 plus 4 minus 1, because there is one king which is included in the 13 cards of heart. So that should be subtracted as it has been counted twice. So 13 plus 4 is 20, 17 minus 1 is 16. In case if we have to find the probability, that will be 16 upon total is 52 cards. On cancellation, we'll have 4 by 13. So for question number 10, the correct answer is 4 by 13. That's option B. 4 by 13 is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 11 is on the screen, and it's again a question from probability. So let's try to figure it out. It's a question based on the concept of dice. Right. So find the probability of getting the total of 9 or more when 2 dice are thrown together. So if 2 dice are thrown together, let's check out the cases. For the sum to be 12, there can be only one case, that is 6 and 6. For the sum 11, there can be a total of 2 cases. It can be 5 and 6 or 6 and 5. For the sum to be 10, there can be a total of 3 cases. It can be 4 and 6 or 5 and 5 or 6 and 4. And for sum to be 9, there can be a total of 4 cases. That's 4 and 5, 6 and 3, 3 and 6, 5 and 4. Right. So a total, when the sum, we want the sum to be 9 or more, a total of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, 10 favorable cases are there. And if 2 dice are rolled together, total cases will be 6 into 6, that is 36. So probability will be 10 upon 36, which on cancellation will give us 5 upon 18 as the correct answer. So for question number 11, option D, 5 upon 18 is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 12 is on the screen. It's a question from time, speed and distance. Okay. So what is given to us? How many minutes does Mr. Surya take? Matlab, what we need to calculate is time to cover a distance of 500 meters. So 500 upon 1000 kilometers, and the speed is 25 kilometer per hour. So in case if I am talking in terms of formula for time, time equals to distance upon speed. Distance is 500 upon 1000 and speed is 25 kilometer per hour. The time that we'll be getting from this equation will be in hours, but the time that we are looking should be in seconds as per the option. So what I'll do is I'll multiply it by 60 to convert it into minutes and a further 60 to convert it into seconds. So now let's try to solve it out. See, double zero, double zero cancel. This is 1, this is 2, this is 1, this is 30, this is 6, this is 5, and this is 1, this is 12. 12 into 6, 72. A total of 72 seconds will be taken by Mr. Surya to cover the distance. So the correct answer is option C, that 72 seconds for question number 12. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 13 is on the screen. It's a question from geometry. So let's try to solve it out. In a triangle ABC, so I'm just drawing a triangle ABC. This is A, this is B, and this is C. AD is the bisector of angle A. So let me draw AD, which is bisector of angle A. Okay. If AC is 4.2 centimeters, and DC is 6 centimeter and BC is 10 centimeter. From this information, we can easily calculate that BC is 10 and DC is 6. So BD should be 4 centimeter. Find AB. So let AB be X. Now, as it is given to us in the question that AB is the angle bisector, so applying the concept of angle bisector theorem, we can say that AB upon AC equal to BD upon CD. AB is X, AC is 4.2 given to us, BD is 4 and BCD is 6. This is 2, this is 3. Right? If I'll multiply it, I'll have X equals to 2 into 4.2 upon 3. Decimal hata, I'll put a 10 in the denominator. This is 1, this is 14. 14 into 2 is 28 upon 10. That should be 2.8 centimeters. So the value of AB will be 2.8 centimeters. So for question number 13, option A, 2.8 centimeters is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question of the presentation. That question is from time speed distance based on the concept of boats and streams. So let's try to figure it out. The speed of a boat in still water is 5 kilometer per hour. So the speed of boat is 5 kilometer per hour. But as we can see in the question, the speed of a stream is not given to us. So let it be y kilometer per hour. It takes twice as much time in going 20 kilometer upstream. Now, since we know that time equals to distance upon speed, and while going upstream, the speed is given as 5 minus y. And while going downstream, the speed will be given as 5 plus y. So while he was traveling a distance of 20 kilometer, time taken is 20 upon speed, that's 5 minus y. And this time is thrice the time taken to cover the same distance in the opposite direction, that is downstream. So it will be 20 upon 5 plus y. Right? If I solve the equation, 20 say 20 will get cancelled out. It will be cross multiplying with 5 plus y equals to 15 minus 3y. This will give us 4y equal to 10, or y equal to 10 upon 4. That's 2.5 kilometers per hour. So what they've asked us is the speed of this stream. That's 2.5 kilometers per hour. So for question number 14, option C, 2.5 kilometers per hour is the correct answer. So with this, we are done with the 14 questions of the topics mentioned in the beginning of the video. In case if you have any doubts, you can post it on our Facebook page. Thank you for watching the video.